Greetings, friends! This is Mr. Koga, and I'm here with our distance learning video for Thursday, May 7th, 2020. All right, today is the 10th distance learning video in this series, and it is the Rainbow Special, the Roy G. Biv, the Color Wheel Special. We're gonna learn about colors, and we're gonna do some art today. And it's a very quick video. There's only gonna be three things we gotta do, all right? First thing is, we're gonna do a mini lesson about the color wheel so we can get familiar with the colors and their relationships to each other. Second thing is, we're gonna go on a color hunt around your house or in your house, and we're gonna try to find things that are certain colors that match the color wheel, and we're gonna try and arrange them in a color wheel pattern, all right? Number three is a read aloud about crayons and how crayons get made, because when I think of color, I think of crayons, art supplies, markers, pens, that kind of stuff. So we're gonna look at, we're gonna read a book about how crayons get made, and we're gonna understand a little bit more about the process that they go through until they make it to our classrooms. All right, well, this is our video for today. I hope you guys enjoy it, and we'll get started. This is Mr. Koga, and I am here with a lesson on the color wheel. And this is one of my favorite things to teach to my students because understanding the color wheel helps you understand the relationships between all these different colors. So I wrote these letters here, and the letters that I wrote are R-O-Y-G-B-I-V. So one thing that can help you to remember what the colors are on the color wheel, or to remember the order for colors in a rainbow, if you want to make a rainbow or if you want to make the rainbow pattern, is you just say this to yourself, Roy G. Biv, Roy G. Biv. So if you can remember Roy G. Biv, that's an acronym for all the letters in the rainbow. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Indigo is a tricky one because not many people, I feel like, know what indigo exactly is, but it is a color in between blue and purple, and it's kind of a mixture of blue and purple put together. It's a very deep color, and it's, it's just one of those in-between colors. I'm kind of interested why they even put that in there, because as you can see, most of the other colors are not really in-between colors. Okay, anyway, so what we're gonna do today is we're gonna make a color wheel, and then we're gonna try and make some connections to this Roy G. Biv that we have over here. Okay, so first thing we're gonna talk about is primary colors. So, primary colors, there are three of them. And the three primary colors are gonna be red, yellow, and blue. The reason why red, yellow, and blue are primary colors is because these colors, you can't make them with other colors. Meaning red is just red. You can't mix two colors together to make red. Same thing goes for yellow, and same thing goes for blue, okay? So I'm just gonna make just a couple of quick little swatches or little patches of color here. So we got the red, we got yellow, and we got the blue. Okay. All right, so now we're gonna look for connections to the next group of colors, which is gonna be called secondary. So secondary colors are basically the primary colors mixed together. So if we take red and yellow and we mix them together, we will get orange. And if you look up here, if we mix red and yellow together, we get the color in the middle, which is orange, okay? So red and yellow makes orange. So I'm gonna put that kind of in between here so we can get a little idea of what that looks like. So red and yellow make orange. Then the next secondary color is yellow and blue mixed together to make green. Yellow and blue. And then our last secondary color is gonna be purple. And that is a mixture of red and blue. So the in-between does not really work for purple or violet, but it kind of makes sense, because if you mix red and blue, then it would make violet. And we'll see that more clearly on the actual color wheel that we're about to make. Because right now it's not super clear because they're all kind of scattered all over the place. But it'll be more clear in a little bit. Okay, so I'm gonna make, why don't we just do this? It doesn't have to be perfect. So red and blue make that. And then this one is gonna be kind of like a tertiary color. That means like a color where three colors get mixed together. And indigo is gonna be that tertiary color, okay? Tertiary means three, or like the third level of colors. And the reason why it's three is because it's red. Well, I guess red and blue plus more blue would make indigo. Okay, but then we'll actually put a circle around this one because this one's kind of like the mystery, like weird, like why are you even here color. Okay, so now we talked about primary colors, then we talked about secondary colors. We'll throw this one in with the secondaries. Okay, so now let's draw a color wheel and let's kind of talk about how these all these colors connect. So what I want you to do now is get a piece of paper and some crayons. You can get markers, you can get paints, you can get whatever you want. Just have something ready to go so that you can follow along. All right, so I'll give you 5 seconds to pause the video and go get your supplies. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Okay, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna make a wheel. So what you wanna do is you wanna make a circle. Doesn't have to be perfect. And then you can make a smaller circle on the inside, okay, to make a wheel. Then what I like to do is I like to cut it into, let's see, so there's gonna be about 7 different pieces. And cutting into 7 pieces is gonna be pretty tough, but let's try and make it work. Okay, so I know if I cut it in half like this, there's 2 pieces. Then I want it to have about 3 here and then 4 here. So if I'm cutting this into 3 pieces, it'll look like that. And if I cut this into 4 pieces, it'll look like that. And that's pretty cool. Just dropped the camera, whoops, in the middle of filming, oh my God. Okay, anyway, we're back. Okay, so now let's go through the Roy G bib one more time. So let's put red, doesn't matter where you put it, but let's just put red on top of here. Okay, and I love these markers. Mrs. Koga got me these markers for my birthday, and they're alcohol-based Arteza markers. So these markers are very special because they can blend and they don't show streaks. Like if you look at that, if you color that with a regular marker, you'd probably get all streaky, but this one doesn't. Okay, so now let's go this way around the color wheel. So now I'm gonna get orange. I'm just gonna follow the Roy G bib, the Roy G bib pattern. There, we got our orange. And then we got our yellow. And so the logic of the color wheel is the colors that are in between are a mixture of the colors. So like this orange color is in between yellow and red. So that means orange is a mixture of yellow and red. All right. So then we're on to the G, which is green. Get that Roy G bib. Okay, so there's the green. Then we're on to the blue. Yeah, so I thought, you know, when I was explaining it earlier, I thought the in-between colors would, like that would be a good way to explain it, but as I'm doing it, you know, I'm learning and I'm figuring out that that's not exactly true for all cases. Because if we look at it, the red and the yellow make orange. The yellow and the blue make green, but orange and green don't make yellow. So I think it kind of matters like where they're placed exactly, but we'll just keep playing with it and talking and hopefully we'll come to an understanding pretty soon, you know, because we're just learning, we're just practicing here. All right, now for the indigo. This color is very deep. It's like a purpley almost. But if you look at it carefully, you can see like this is a very dark blue and it looks like it almost has some purple inside of it. And that's why it's called indigo. It's that in-between color. All right, and our last one is gonna be purple. Honestly, you could just say Roy G Boov and take out the eye, because that might actually work a little better. Roy G Boov. Because if you took this out, then the red and blue make purple, red and yellow make orange, yellow and blue make green. All right, and that's our color wheel. So the color wheel is very, very important. It's an awesome thing to know, just a good skill to have. If you can make this and understand the primary colors and the secondary colors, then art will be a lot easier for you because you understand colors a little bit better. All right, okay, hope you enjoyed this lesson on the color wheel. Now we're gonna move into a lesson about colors and finding colors either in your house or outside. And we're gonna make a color wheel with some things we find. All right, here we are in Mr. Coco's backyard. I feel like you guys know my backyard better than I do almost at this point. You guys have seen it in pretty much every single video. All right, so I brought out the color wheel that I made, and I'm gonna use this just kind of as a guide, just to make sure I have all the colors. And I also brought out a separate piece of paper, or I might use the back of this paper, just so that I can start laying out the things that I find in the right order. So I'm gonna start looking for things that match our color wheel. So I wanna find some reds, I wanna find some oranges, yellows, greens, wonder where I'm gonna find that, some blues, maybe it's an indigo if I can find one, and a purple. So it depends on what, you know, what's in your backyard or what's around your house, and some of these things may be harder to find than others. So I'm gonna try and find things just found, you know, found items. But if I have to, I might cut some, like a flower or two off of a tree or something like that. But I'm only gonna do that if I know that there are tons of them and me cutting them won't hurt or really harm them very much, okay? So yeah, let's start cut to a clip of me finding different things and then we'll put them all together in a cool color wheel pattern. All right, here we go. Ah, red. You can definitely harvest these. Ah, orange. Perfect. Mellow yellow, there we go. Green leaves. Ooh, and the hardest one to find so far. Blue on this bird of paradise. Got it. All right, well, we're back inside. I was gonna film this video outside. It was such a nice day, but our neighbor has their gardeners over, so it is super loud outside. All right, but anyway, so I looked at the color wheel and I went to go find all these colors, and guess what? We found them! And they actually turned out really great. This was actually a lot more fun than I expected. So I did harvest some of these items, and I found some of these items, but the ones that I did harvest, I made sure that they came from a plant that was very plentiful. It wasn't like a plant that if I took it, it would harm it very much. Okay, so let's go around the Roy G. Biv spectrum and let's figure out what we found. So, I found this. This is from the bottle brush tree. In Hawaiian, it's called Ohia Lehua. So this is the bottle brush tree, and it makes a lot of this fun little little bristles that come off the bottle brush, because it looks like a bottle brush that you would stick in a bottle and clean. All right, so we got the red with the Ohia Lehua, or bottle brush. Next, the orange. We have a lot of these growing in my garden, or not garden, but in my backyard right now. And this is an orange poppy. So the orange poppy is a very pretty, delicate flower, and it grows a lot during springtime. So there's the poppy. So red, orange. Now for the yellow. The yellow, I found this little, I think it's a daisy. It looks like a little daisy looking plant. But this one, I actually didn't notice that we had this in my backyard. So kind of cool, because I learned a little bit more about my own space. Obviously the green, these leaves came from the hibiscus plant. I like this because, as you know, Mr. Koga grew up in Hawaii and this reminds me a lot of home. Both of these do, the Ohia Lehua and the hibiscus. Make me homesick a little bit. But yeah, it's just a little nostalgia rush for me. All right, so the blue, this was by far the hardest color to find, and I was surprised that I even was able to find any blue. This blue, as you saw from the earlier in the video, this blue came from the little beak part from the bird of paradise. Again, another plant from Hawaii. Wow, I think almost majority of these plants came from plants from Hawaii, but this one was the hardest to find, by far, the blue. And that's one thing that I noticed, that in this area, maybe where I live in Oxnard, blue is a very hard color to come by in nature. And the last one was this beautiful purple flowery plant that just blooms randomly. We don't really know why or, you know, what kind of plant it is, but it blooms all the time and randomly. We don't know when. It just dies and looks like it's dead and it comes back to life. Well, there you go. That is our color wheel from nature, and it was really fun to do that. So hopefully you made your color wheel by following the example that I did earlier, and then you went outside or in your house and you found your own color wheel of found objects. All right, hope you enjoyed this lesson. I had a lot of fun doing it. Greetings, my friends. This is Mr. Koga, and I'm here with our read aloud for today. Since it is the Roy G. Biv episode or the rainbow episode, we're going to read a book about how crayons are made, because I think crayons remind everyone of colors, and that's what we're focusing on today, is colors. All right, so this book is called How Is It Made? Crayons by Vanessa Black. So in this book, readers will learn about the process by which wax and colored pigments are transformed into a beloved coloring tool. All right, so there's three chapters: mixing, molding, and wrapping. And then there's a couple other extra things at the end. So this is a chapter book. Also, if you check the description below, you'll find timestamps for all the activities, as well as a cool How It's Made video that I saw about crayons. So if you want to check that out after this video is done, please do. All right, chapter one, mixing. What is your favorite crayon to color with? Orange? Light blue? Lemon yellow? Crayons come in more than 100 shades, from apricot to violet. Have you ever wondered how crayons are made? How does the forest get into forest green? Let's find out. Crayons start out as a wax mixture. The wax begins with paraffin, a type of wax made from oil. Paraffin has good rub-off. When you color, some of the crayon comes off on the page. And this is a picture of paraffin right here. This is used in a lot of different things. I know this is used for crayons, but it's also used in like the makeup industry. I think you can use it for like your skin. You can do like hot wax dips and stuff. The wax is heated. It all becomes a liquid. Ooh, so it went from a solid into a liquid by heating it. A dry powder called pigment is added. Pigment is what gives a crayon its color. The wax and pigment are mixed together until the color is uniform. And then we'll go down here to Did You Know? Did you know? The first crayons meant for children were made in 1903. The original pack had red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, brown, and black. Wow. The Roy G. Biv right there. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet. All right, so very interesting. So over 100 years ago, that's when crayons were actually invented. Very interesting. Chapter 2, molding. Once the color is just right, the crayons are ready to be molded. Let me move myself. The mixture is poured into a mold machine. This metal machine is full of crayon-shaped molds. So it's very similar to how they make toys, how they make like candies. If you've ever seen like the little, like I think like gummy bears are made that way, lollipops, like all sorts of candies. When the molds are full of the colored mixture, they are placed in cold water. This makes the wax cool and harden. After the crayons are cool, the machine pushes them out. Any extra wax that didn't fit into the mold is scraped off. It is melted and reused. Did you know prominent crayon manufacturer Crayola makes more than 3 billion crayons a year? If you line them up end to end, they could circle around the earth 6 times. Wow. My God. That's really cool that they reuse the colors too. And you can do that at home too. You could melt the crayons down in your oven. You could reuse them and make new colors that, or you can make a crayon with a bunch of different colors in one single crayon. Chapter 3, wrapping. Look at all the crayons. Can you see what they're missing? Labels. Oh my God, it's like the day the crayons quit and all the crayons are naked. A machine puts labels on the crayons. Then the crayons fall onto a moving belt. Wow, so you can see the huge roll of the labels here and all the crayons falling down to this moving belt and someone picks them up. How do the crayons look? Are any chipped? Are any broken? Does the color seem right? Quality control workers check each crayon. They pick out the ones that are not perfect. These are recycled. Did you know? Labels have three purposes. They name the color, they keep your fingers clean while you're coloring, and they make the crayon stronger. Crayons break more easily if they do not have paper labels. Oh, I didn't even realize that. But have you ever tried to peel a crayon before or peel the paper off a crayon? Because most of the time there's like some glue on it. But if you wrap the paper and you use a little bit of glue, that does make it stronger. That adds a little more structural integrity to the crayon. Workers pick up the crayons from the belt. They carry them to a sorting machine. It puts one crayon of each color into a box. Wow, that's cool. So they put all the crayons into this machine, and then this machine drops one of each crayon into a box. That's so cool. Actually, these crayons look like they're kind of triangular. They have like a triangle barrel. It's cool. The boxes are ready. Are you? What do you want to color? How does a crayon take shape? Mixing, molding, labeling, and sorting. All right, that's so cool. Oh, and like I just said, you can make your own recycled crayons. So what you need is broken crayons, muffin tins, nonstick cooking spray, and an adult to help you. So you can make a crayon, and if you want, you can go on Amazon or something and buy like candy molds. So you can buy some like in the shape of like Legos, in the shape of teddy bears, like anything that you can make a candy out of, you could make a recycled crayon out of too. Super cool. All right, well, and that's the book for today. We finished our book and we earned some points. 12 minutes of reading time. Very nice, guys. Okay, and that was our book for today. Hope you enjoyed today's video. It was the Roy G. Biv episode, aka the Rainbow episode, and I hope you guys had a good time watching it because I had a good time making it. So have a good one. Enjoy your weekend.